Hello, this is RSCKY, the Android guy. Alright guys, so today I wanted to show you something new with the Verizon Galaxy Nexus, and that is, it finally has Jelly Bean! Yay! As most of you may know, the Verizon is the last one to have Jelly Bean on the Galaxy Nexus, and since it's the one I had access to, I did want to show you an update on what are the differences with Jelly Bean. So I'm going to go over a few of those. So first of all, on the lock screen, if you have a slide to unlock, you can now not only go from the unlock and also to the left to the camera, but now you can go up to an icon that says Google, which will look like this, and I'll go over that in a second. So that's what you can do on the unlock screen. Now, in terms of the lock screen, we can also do a couple of, in terms of the actual phone, there's a couple of differences you're going to notice. One is the top notification bar, and it's because it has been redone with the new voice search that is really amazing. So if you want to find out certain things like, what is the population of Los Angeles? It'll come up with the exact number. Now, sometimes it will do just the top search with its knowledge bar, and sometimes it will actually speak the answer to you. So say if I said, who's the current president of the United States?
The president of the United States of America is Barack Obama.
So sometimes you'll get what's called a card, which will actually be the answer for that. So those are two differences. Now you can also use this to set up reminders or find out what's your favorite team's score right now. So my friend who has this phone really likes the Yankees, so I'm going to say, when's the next time the Yankees are playing?
The Yankees are playing the Red Sox tomorrow at 4:05 p.m.
So really quick, very accurate as well. This voice search has actually beat out Siri and S-Voice on the Galaxy S3 as well as the iPhone 5. So it's really accurate. And in terms of everything else, another thing you can do is actually set reminders. So say, reminder, I need to leave the studio in 30 minutes.
Setting alarm.
It'll actually set it if you don't not push the X button. So I did push the X button to cancel it, but that's another thing that it automatically sets it up. So if you set a reminder for yourself, even while driving, you actually don't need to push it to make it set it. It'll actually automatically set it. So things like that make it really useful. Another thing is you can automatically rearrange your screen. And now my friend has a calendar right here at the top and some icons right here, but what if you wanted to switch it up? Well, then I could just simply grab this and then move it. So it's really nice and convenient that you can actually rearrange things a lot easier now. Say if I wanted this power bar right here, right here, right here, here, you know, wherever I kind of want it to go. And this is another feature that just makes Jelly Bean really easy. It also is a lot smoother, especially when going through certain things. It's basically been optimized, so that's just another thing that's really nice. Another thing is the notification panel. Now, you use this by using two fingers to make things smaller or expand. So one thing, all Google services will obviously use this, and as other apps become more used to it, they will also use these types of things. So the real thing that's important is, say like Google Voice, right now I could actually see my the message that I left for text messages. I could actually see that as well. And, you know, I could just basically see, oh, you have a voicemail from him. And you can also see from missed calls. The missed call one I really like because it just allows you to call the person back right there or message them. So it's just a really nice feature that it has within it, and just a feature that I really like. Now, another thing is with Google Now. Now, I will go back to this, but it's telling me there's traffic. This is how much traffic to get to this Japanese restaurant that has sushi, and there's a reason why. So at one point, I knew my friend liked sushi, so I searched, oh, what's the best sushi place around here? And what that allowed me to do is actually on Google Now. Google Now is an app that actually learns what you like. So the reason why that's so cool is because basically you can actually really have it learn your searches without ever needing to search again. So, just gonna notice my battery's low here. So it's telling me, because I searched the sushi place before, it found this good sushi place that's around here. And I can easily navigate to it right then and there. I'm gonna zoom in more so you guys can see the cards better. Another thing is, because I searched for the Yankees before, it tells me the last score of their game. Also, I can go into the box score or the recap and highlight reel. Now remember, I did not search for this, it just knows that I want to see it, which is really cool. If you're ever even at work now and you want to know the latest thing on the Yankees game and you have this phone, all you have to do is go to Google Now and it immediately has all the updates for you. So that's just really cool. You don't even have to search for it, it just knows. Also, he likes the Chicago Bears, so I have the game that's going to be tomorrow for that already. Of course, the weather. And also, different things on how to improve the location, on where he is right now. Now, the other things it'll have is you can actually have it set to where you want, how long it's going to take you to get home and how long it's going to take you to get to work. So if there's ever a change in traffic, you can actually have it so that it automatically takes you, it automatically notifies you, hey, you know, normally it takes you 15 minutes to get home, now it's going to take you 30 minutes to get home. So it'll actually notify you in the notification panel. Now you can also have it do it like this, where it'll notify you when there's a good food place of the same kind of food you'd like to have. So these are just features in Google Now. It's really good. Another thing you can do is you can actually act, once Google Now is open, you can actually just say Google. You don't have to push the search button. So you can actually just do that as well. So all these features can be found in the Galaxy Nexus with Jelly Bean. So if you haven't got the update, you should get it by no later than tomorrow, as according to Verizon. All of them should have it by October 1st. And those are a few of the features that you have now. So, hope you like it. If you have any questions for me, feel free to ask. This has been RSCKY, the Android Guy.